Instagram is mostly a passive scrolling experience, but every now and then I find an account where I want to explore their content a little bit more. So I'll go to the Reels tab, and usually I find myself scrolling through random freeze frames that don't tell me what each reel is about. I think this works fine if your content is more broad or entertainment based. For example, if your account is about dogs, I'll click on all the reels regardless of the frames that are being shown. But if your content is more specific, or if you do tutorial-based content like me, it can be really helpful to design your reel covers the same way you would your YouTube thumbnails, where you include some text about what your video is about. I think this can give your reels a little bit more shelf life, especially for someone who may have discovered you in the Explore tab or just scrolling through random reels. Then they like your content so much, they decide to actively go directly to your page and scroll through your content. So in this video, I'm going to show you how I designed my template that I've been using for Instagram reel covers in Canva. Let's get started. So in Canva, I'm going to go to the search bar and type in Instagram reel cover. And this has a default template with the correct size. So that's what I'm gonna click on. And then it's gonna show me all these templates that they have. The templates are great, but after scrolling, they just seemed really, I don't know, lifestyle-y, like too lifestyle-y for my taste. So I decided to just make my own. So I went all the way here, create a blank Instagram cover, and then it's probably sized. Now, I think because you are picking a reel, it's going to be a video by default, but I'll show you how to export it as an image. So this is the one that I've already made, and here are the past three that I've made. So there are three things to keep in mind when designing the covers. First is that we obviously want to include searchable or specific text. That's the whole point of doing this. The second thing is that it has to look good in the Reels grid in terms of none of that text that we just added being cut off, and then also being mindful of what it looks like in the profile grid. So the profile grid is a square, which means that probably the text isn't going to show up, because in the profile grid, I'd rather have it focused on an image rather than text. But for the Reels cover, we can include the text because it's a vertical aspect ratio. So all that to say, I'll just rebuild this one from scratch. So I'll add a page here and I'll put it right next to it. And the first thing that I do is I put a background in the back. I think I used this picture. So I put this in the back, and I'm not gonna use this photo because it's really dark, but let me adjust. How do I crop this? Of course, when I decided to record this video, Canva completely did an update on its interface. So if I'm like, where are things? That's why. So there's that, you know, my purple background. And then what I did was, here is the image that I actually used. And I went over to edit, and then I'm gonna hit background mover. I think this is a pro feature. I have Canva Pro. And then that is going to remove the image. So I'm actually gonna crop the photo so that it doesn't have the desk. So it's just me here, and I'm just gonna position myself like I'm sitting at the desk. I'm going to make it bigger, and then I'm going to put a white outline around myself just to make myself pop a little bit more. So I'm gonna go into the effects section and then hit shadows, and then I'm going to hit outline right here, and it's going to put a black outline by default, but I'm going to switch that to white. That line is a little bit too thick for me, so I'm going to make it a little bit smaller like that, and there we go. So I'm going to do some quick editing on the photo because it is also a little bit dark, so I'm going to brighten myself up a bit. Let's see, up the contrast just a tad. Add some vibrance, and we're good. Now, the other thing I do is whatever I use for the background photo, as you can see here for this one, I didn't use my studio. I used like a brick wall. I always darken the back one so that it just puts a little bit more depth with the subject, which is me. So I'm gonna click on the background here and then edit. I'm gonna go to adjust and decrease the brightness just a little bit. Next up is the text. So plenty of text options in Canva. The thing that I wanted to add, the subject of this video, was the model of this keyboard since that's what this reel was about. So basically what I did was I just added some basic text here, and I'll just, I think I did it all on one line like this. And we're gonna change that to, I think I did the green. Let's make this way bigger like that. And we're gonna put it towards the lower third of the image, because I know that for the profile grid, it's probably just gonna cut out the middle square. I think you actually might be able to adjust it for the profile grid, but I'm going to assume that the text isn't gonna show up in the profile grid, but it will show up in the Reels grid. So here we go. I'm going to add a neon glitch effect. Neon glitch. I kind of like the neon. I don't think that's what I did, but okay, so it's a little hard to read. So what I do is I go into elements and I try to find something to put in the background. So you could do like, you know, a rectangle. I'm pretty sure I did like a paint splatter, like something like this. Yeah, something like this. And then I just put it behind like that. You can change the color of this one. I'm pretty sure I would have cropped it a little bit like this. Boom. Like that, something like that. Say I changed it to a darker purple just so it's not black. Okay, cool. Then under text, is it under text? No, if you scroll down here, there are different apps now that you can install with Canva. And so they have one called Text Maker, which I've really been having a lot of fun with. And that's what I used to insert the word keyboard. And I think the way that you do it now is we're gonna pick a template, I guess. Oh, this one's kind of cool. Let's try something different. Let's try this. And then we're gonna do keyboard. Let's make it like that. Cool. Add to design, and here we are. You can adjust the size as necessary, like this. Cool, something like that, right? Maybe I can fix this so it's not, so it's a little bit bigger to fit all of the text. Cool, something like that. Then it was looking a little bit dark up here. So I go to elements and I try to find things that are accents. I mean, there's so many things you could do. You could do like light, and you can actually add like a light in the corner of your photo. This is kind of cool. Something like this, like little bursts. I've been a fan of the neon lately, so I did neon. So you, I mean, even if you did like how cool is this, right? Something like this, and then you can crop one side of this like that, and then just have that be like that. Well, that's like cool, right? And then we can put this here, flip this, and we got the other side, something like that. Maybe we put something on the top. Let's try this. No, that's a no-go. Something like, I don't know, this is kind of loud, but you can kind of get an idea of what I'm going for, right? Like just something to add a little bit more pop there. I know here what I did was like the corners and then this little expression thing on the side of my head. Oh, and then I put something here too. But you can see that you can add all kinds of elements that you just have to get kind of creative with what you're searching for. To export this, again, it's going to be a video since we use a template, but I'm gonna click on share and I'm gonna hit download right here. And for the file type, we're gonna change this to JPEG, and I'm gonna increase the quality because I'm gonna increase the quality. Then I'm going to change this to the current page and go ahead and download that and export the file. After I export the file, I would airdrop that file to my phone, upload the reel or the video on Instagram, and then you'll be taken to this screen. Now, where it says edit cover, I'm gonna tap that, And here you're going to be able to scrub through your video and select a frame to use as the cover image. But what we're going to do is actually hit add from camera roll and then add the image that we just created in Canva. And you can see it shows up right there. And that is a preview of what it's going to look like in the Reels grid. But you can tap the tab here where it says profile grid. I'm going to adjust this so the text doesn't show, but the subject shows, right? So that's me holding the keyboard. That looks great. So I'm going to hit done and that's it. Now, I haven't figured out a way to do this with YouTube Shorts aside from including this frame at the end of the video and then scrubbing to that frame and selecting it as the cover. But if you know how to swap out thumbnails or change thumbnails on YouTube Shorts, let me know in the comments. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one.